Here's a term you may not have heard before, and we didn't know how to say it until just now. Taylor was right. It's algal bloom. It's a rapid increase in algae population in freshwater or marine water systems. Under the right conditions, algae may grow out of control, and a few of these blooms can produce toxins that can kill fish, mammals, and birds, and may even cause human illness or even death in extreme cases.
So what do you need to do or to stay safe? Dr. Brandon Bentley is with the Department of Family and Community Medicine with Wellstar MCG Health, and he's joining us this morning.
Good morning, guys.
Yes.
Good morning.
Good to see you guys.
I'm still getting over the fact you don't put anything on your hot dogs.
Yeah, habit from childhood. I don't like ketchup, I don't like mustard, and so those are only options when we're at a cookout when you're a kid, so it stuck with me.
Okay, all right. That'll be another subject for another day.
Yes.
Let's talk about this algal bloom.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
After hot dogs. What is an algal bloom, and how can I identify one if I'm going out in the water?
Yeah, so these are overgrowths of algae or cyanobacteria, so that green-blue stuff that you see floating on top of water, that is an overgrowth of algae. So if you start to see something that is like that blue-green, sometimes it's red, if it discolors the water, if it smells a little bit strange, that's likely an algal bloom, and you probably shouldn't jump into that water, you shouldn't drink that water, and you should probably keep your pets, or if you have livestock, away from that water as well.
So how can this be harmful to you?
So some of these blooms can release toxins or gases, whether it's from consumption or just breathing the air nearby. In fact, if you've ever heard of red tide, it was off the Gulf Coast of Florida, right, usually in a seasonal pattern. They've even found that the toxins released by that algae can be found up to 4 miles inland from the ocean. I know we mentioned the ocean, but it's not necessarily just an ocean thing. This is a waterway thing. Ponds, lakes, rivers, streams, oceans, you name it, can be found in freshwater, saltwater, brackish water. So we can lead to these problems of either stomach upset or even some respiratory concern as a result of these toxins or gases that are being released as a result of this algae overgrowth.
So really not a good thing for anybody at all. What causes an algal bloom?
So these happen as a result of extra nutrients in the water. This can happen from runoff from cities, from fertilizer, overuse from industries, or even your own yard. So this is why it's really important to follow the directions if you're gonna be doing your own fertilization of your landscaping. So anytime that, like after big rainstorms, if it's running off, even sewage, that gets into the waterways, that's just extra nutrients for this algae to be able to consume and grow and just become more of a problem.
You kind of mentioned this just a second ago, but let's talk about the actual symptoms if you get infected or come across this algal bloom.
Yeah, so if this is something that you might come across, whether it's in your own area or if you're consuming water that might be affected by it as well, can have stomach aches, runny nose, itchy eyes. You can get some respiratory problems. So those who are prone, if you have any underlying respiratory illnesses, would be a little bit more prone to a respiratory condition as a result of the algal blooms. And when you see it in your pets, you might see vomiting or lethargy, so just being a little bit more tired. So you just want to know where your pets have been, or if you have livestock, where they're getting their water sources from.
And what should you do if you notice an algal bloom in water near you, or you think you have come in contact with one?
Yeah, so let's talk about if you've come in contact first. So if you think that you're having some symptoms as a result of it, you can talk with your physician, or you can call the poison control line to let them know that this is something you've been exposed to, you're having symptoms of, and get some guidance as to what to do next. And if you see it in your local waterways, you can actually reach out to the Georgia Environmental Protection Agency to let them know that this is something that's nearby where you are. Let them know where you've seen this, and then they can advise you what to do next or come on out and take a look to see if there's anything that needs to be done.
And there's also a local group here, the Savannah Riverkeeper, always checking to make sure that levels are good across the area, too. Always good information. It's good to see you.
Thank you.
You had something else you wanted to say.
Yes. So very big, important stuff. Yesterday was my dad's birthday, so I want to take a quick moment to say happy birthday, Dad. I hope it was a lot of fun, and I can't wait to see you soon.